Oh, by the way, hello.
And there was this snakes and ladders and this snakes and ladders. On the other side, this one's got Ludo. It's weird, isn't it, how most of the time on the back of the board game of snakes and ladders, there's also Ludo. Very weird. I love it that in the Spanish, it's got it written in Spanish. And they call it Serpentines y Escalaris. I think if it was a modern computer game version of Snakes and Ladders, they could call it Escalators and Descendulators, because I think an escalator going downwards should be called a descendulator. I've said that before. Anyway, we're going to look at this one first, because it's weird. What's going on? Look at that. What is going on? These look like beads. And they've got some sort of flicky arrow thing. What? It's weird. And there's no Ludo on the back of this one. It's just the same. Okay, so we'll get this one open. This is where it falls on its head, because obviously... So I taped it down. It's sealed for freshness. What was I going to say? Oh, could I just get underneath? Yeah, then there'd be one last bit of sellotape to undo. What was I going to say? Can't remember now. Hopefully I'll remember. I hate when I forget what I'm talking about. So inside this, there's a hard plastic tray. Oh, this actually looks better than it does on the front, I think. That's weird. Usually it's the other way around, isn't it? But my arrow's missing, so yep, that's in there. And we've got some sort of table thing. That's weird. So it rests upwards. It's got two little legs on. And on the other side, it doesn't. Yeah, well, so it's make it easier for the camera. So there you go. And it's got the instructions. Four players, how to play. Let's see. Oh, good, we have got the pieces. And the arrow doesn't even have an arrow on the front of it. It's snapped off. It snapped off. Am I meant to have a proper... Yeah! I'm meant to have a proper pointy bit. And a dirt. Oh, that's a bit annoying. Anyway, let's get into this. There we go. Now, it's only meant to be four players, but they've given me some extra beads. And they're not quite beads. They're really weirdly formed. I hope you can get them on the camera that... See what I mean? It's like a little lens running through them. If we get all of them. I'll take my broken arrow out. These must be made so incredibly cheaply. Anyway, let's get my arrow in. It's not even right to call it an arrow, really, is it? If it's not even an arrow. Right, so that clicks in there. Wow, this isn't fiddly at all. Oh my word. It's a really hot day as well. It's boiling hot. And the last thing I want to be doing right now is really fiddly work. Oh, I got it in. Does it work? Yeah. It does. But I would have appreciated the extra arrow because it would have been easier to flick. Right, so where do these go then? Because there's nowhere to put them. Oh, I see now. Instead of it being proper full... So, yeah, there you go. Because you don't start on one, do you? You got to... Well, normally you've got a roll of six with a dice. Or a die, if you will. But this is a... Only goes up to four. And you could be flicking all day. Yeah, got a four. There we go. Then you flick again. And see, would that first flick have counted as a flick even though I missed? So really, I should have gone forward. Four. Right, move forward one space. So I go nowhere. Oh. But this is daft because the weight of the arrow means it's going to generally be along the bottom. Maybe not, because I don't think it's particularly well made, obviously. So I've got another four. One, two, three, four. Yay, I go up the ladder. I think you call it shoots and snakes or something in America, don't you? Something like that, anyway. Yeah, we'll give it another flick. This isn't going to take too long at all, is it? And it goes up to 36. What's that? That is 2. So, 1, 2. Oh, then we'll go up another ladder. Ah, you see, this slanted thing does have mean a tendency for these to keep sliding down. So you'd have to keep an eye on it. So if you've got a brother and sister who likes cheating at board games, they might just keep going like this on the table until it rolls down and up that you forget. Right, so I've got another 3, so 1, 2, 3. Oh, come on, we're through already. 4. Why'd you go after a yeah? 22. There's 22, where's 23? See, that's a big leap, isn't it? 22, 23, 24. 25, 26. Oh, no. Oh, that was, it was fun. That is quite fun. Until it rolls off the desk or table, whatever you're playing it on. So now I'm stuck at number 15 again. 2. Rolled off. I should be on number 17 now, shouldn't I? So 17. Yay, I got up to 23. Oh, another flick to the camera then instead of the thing. Oh! 17. Where was I? I was on 23, wasn't I? 23, 24, 25. Oh my word, again. I thought this was going to be a really quick game. 20, 14, 16, 18. Should be on now. I hate the big snake in Snakes and Ladders. 1. 3. 1, 2, 3. Well, I'm already at the bottom of the snake there, so that don't count. 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. You have got to be kidding me. The game is rigged. It's rigged, I'm telling you. 2. 17. I'm up again. 23. Oh, stop it. 1. 2. Oh, my word. Really? 4, 16, 17, 18, 19, 4, 1, 2, 3, 3, it's rigged! I can't possibly be this bad at Snakes and Ladders. This is stupid. Oh my word. I bet so many of you have jumped ahead by now. You're thinking, I'm watching someone play Snakes and Ladders on their own. 1. I'm going to get to the top if it kills me. I might have to speed this up. So, 16. 3. 1, 2, 3. 1. Oh, no! 1. 9. 10. 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, that's it. I've had enough of that one now. Let's get on to the next one. Anything hilarious on the instructions? It's just a slice of paper that big. I thought it was folded over and it's not. It's quite thick, really. I suppose they saved money and just printed that on the inside of the box or something. Snakes and Ladders. 4 players. How to play. Begin each player spinning the arrow in the centre. The player with the highest number goes first. Oh, so they've decided to have the highest number goes first. Player then continues to the left. Okay. Spin the arrow and move the number of places shown. If you land on the snake's head, your counter slides down to the tail. If you land at the bottom of the ladder, your counter, well, bead, climbs to the top of that ladder. Winning the game. The first player to land on circle 44 is the winner. I was going to say, is he a 44? And what is that bit there? Oh, that must just be the winning thing where you just land. I see. And then that's it. But you must have the correct number on the spinner to land on this circle. Good luck, it says. And then it goes into the other language. So that's Snakes and Ladders for £1. But then also for £1, you get this. So you could get the game with 50p a game. Let me just get this one back in the box. To be never played again. these beads in there. Now, see, how weird would it be if there's some actually higher quality? I'm glad they supplied loads of beads because they're so going to get lost. I keep calling them beads, but they're not beads in real life. But they are on the box. Very bizarre. This is made by GN Games. I don't know if that's Poundland's own thing. Two exciting games to play. It lied. Ludo, Snakes and Ladders with a very, very happy snake. And it looks as if this one's got a proper dice in it. Oh, die. Let's get the plastic off, which opened remarkably easy. I got into this easier than the other one. Same thing again, written in Spanish on one side, not on the other. Right, there we go. And it's quite nice. I actually prefer the packaging on this one, actually. It's like a proper board game as well. So it's, you take the lid off. Oh, the salad tipped it shut as well. Oh, really? Oh, it lost its point. Oh, God. Let's get some scissors or a pen to stab that salad tape. Hang on a minute. There we go. Found a pen. You are joking me! I've just broke my pen! Oh, and I've got green ink all over me. Oh, my word. Suppose I'll use scissors then. Oh, got ink all over me. Looks like I've got green blood. There we go. That would like work, isn't it? Use scissors. Whenever cutting anything open, use scissors. I'm hoping it's just two bits of sellotape. And it was good. Oh, that's nice and colourful. That's really nice. And look at the pieces as well. They're more shaped. Ooh, this is not going to last long. You might want to immediately get a bit of sellotape on this. Sellotape, if you will. Because that is going to get a line through it very quickly. So, proper snakes and ladders, you can see. It goes all the way up to 100. Have I got it all in? No, I haven't. I want to pull this back a bit, I think. There we go. Now I've got you all in. There you go. So it goes all the way up to 100. Some of the snakes are a bit confusing. I mean, where's that going? Oh, there. It's a very twisty snake. And that I actually quite like this. It actually looks quite fun. The ladders are a bit boring though, aren't they? It's like they've put all the effort into the snakes and the ladders are just being drawn on afterwards. So they look a bit boring. I think they barely even show up on the camera, actually. Yeah. Well, they actually barely show up in real life. Let's make sure I've got it all in. Yeah, that'll do. Is it all in? Yeah. I can put these scissors somewhere safe. Don't leave scissors lying around. Right. So inside, the pieces. Well, the dice looks a bit shoddy. It looks like a really brittle sweet, actually. Let's get this open. Right. So you've got all these pieces, obviously, because of Ludo on the other side. Oh! How many have I got? So one, two, three, four blue, four orange, four green, and four red. Oh. Gravity is really not helping me today, is it? And this dice looks actually quite misshapen. Once again, I don't know if it's going to come across on camera, but this is not exactly a cuboid. It really isn't. So I think it's going to be a bit unfair. I wonder how it rolls. Yeah, 2, 5. Oh, that's a good word. Is that coming across on camera? How much that wobbles? It's not a cube at all. 2, 5. 6, 5,
5, 1, 6, 1, 1. Just making sure it's throwing fairly. So far I've only had 1, 6 and 5, haven't we? 1, 6, 5 and 4. 1, 6, 5, 4. Have we had any 3s yet? Yeah, I don't think it's ever going to land on 3. Has it even got a 3? Just getting the same numbers over and over again. Well, it's going to make the game a lot quicker. Oh, there was a 3. We got a 3 in the end. So 6, 4, 1, 3, 5, 2. Yeah, that's all the numbers, isn't it? Right, you never know, just in case. And there's the Ludo side, which actually looks quite good as well. I quite like this. Very colourful. And it's Ludo, there's not much more to say really. So the pieces are quite firm. And I think for a quid, this is actually quite good. I'll do that and that. So if you're in Poundland and you see, we'll put the rest of the pieces in there so we don't lose them. So if you're in Poundland and you see, but put them on this side of the box, these two games, I think you should obviously go for this one. Because not only is it 2 for 1, but you're also getting a much better quality of board game, really. And for a quid, who cares if it gets trashed? But you could always leave this, maybe in the glove compartment of your car, so if it gets stuck in traffic and the phone has died, I think it'd be good to have something like this. Anyway, I'm old school, so I quite like board games still. I think these days kids will be like, what's a board game? Anyway, thanks for watching. Please scratch. That's my review of Ludo Snakes and Ladders. And Snakes and Ladders. They also get an extra point for using the ampersand and not using the word "n", because that's what an ampersand is for. We don't need an "n". We've got ampersand. Thanks for watching. Scratch. Bye. Bye. Bit of an extra point. I just took this out of the bottom of the box, and for rigidity, they've just shoved a poorly piece cut of cardboard. Look at that. I wonder if I take that out, I wonder if it's got anything written underneath it. Hang on. No, it's just a piece of cardboard for rigidity. It's got some weird lines in it. Oh, very odd.